This is a tips and tricks I learned in playing the Manor Lords for many hundred hours. Please tell me in the comments if you know every tips and tricks here. This is mostly for beginners, also for those who have played very long time. Let's go to number one. If you want to build a city in a forest area, and you make a road, it's kind of hard to see, right? And you can easily just remove the forest and where you want to expand your city with making fields. And then it's much easier to see what you're doing. First thing you should do when you're starting a new area is to build carrot plots. Because they take 3 years to produce food and it's one of the best food in game. This is not important the size, but what is important is how you build it after. So you take just one step and then you drag the line as long as you can. And then you just fill out. And this is okay because it's more efficient. I'm gonna show you one more time. You take one step, follow as long as you can, and you get these fields. And if you do work on this, you can even get better than that. Let's try other way around. And you see there, if I hold the line, it will move. This line will move. So this is much more efficient because they have more fields and they don't need to walk so long. And there's no dead space. If you want to build cool city, like a circle, you need to test with F. You can scroll in to, if you want a smaller circle, scroll out and move your camera angle. Then you push R and click and F. Don't move your mouse. This is how you make a circle in Manor Lords. If you don't like the position of the camping ground, this is kind of common thing. Just take the corpse pit that is free, put it over the hunting ground area, and it will move. Usually, I try to move it close to the berries so they can collect in the same area. When the start of the game, it's usually best to order an ox and have a new hitching post, because everything is so slow with only one ox. And you find the hitching post under storage tab. One of the first thing you should do when you start a new city is to make a granary and a storage to get the stuff inside the starting supplies. Because when rain or winter comes, it will get destroyed if it's out in the weather. And you can also put high priority to make sure they build that first. But remember to put one people in each so they can pick up the supplies. And when they've done that, you can take them off. Use them somewhere else. Another circle tip. You do the same. Push R and click F and you make this circle. And if you don't touch anything and just scroll with your mouse, you can make a new circle. And this will be perfect inside the other circle. You can make really cool design with this type of circles. The distance will be perfect all the way around and you can have all kind of design in here. Maybe you want fields. You can also do a larger circle. The trading post is best to have closest to the border as you can. But since I have the city here, it's okay to put it down here. But if you build a city down towards the border, because then it will have a closer route to the trade point. Well, it's really good food source, but if you're going for apple, you should take that really fast, because it takes really long time for the apple trees to grow up. And basically you do the same as the witches. You see here is more effective with the bigger fields and not so much dead space. They will give us a little bit apple. In 5 years you will get full production of apples. Plan for the future. Protect your berries with field. Just go to the farm tab, take a farmhouse and see where the berries is. It's in red and take a field around it so you cover all the berries. As you can see here, it's still 128 of 128. And this way the logging camp or the woodcutter lodge will not destroy the berries and cut down the trees. They are protected forever now. For a rich berry deposit, the best way to collect everything is to have 6 butcher huts. Of course, in the start, when you don't have people, you start with one. And usually you only need 1 people each hut. If you don't have money to make apple fields, because it costs 50, the easiest way to get money in the start is to make a saw pit. Take it close to the logging camp, because they need timber. to work, and then you go to the trader and you go to export and you say you want 20, so you have some surplus for the church and other things, and then you sell the rest. And you, of course, you need to have one people there, and this will get you some money. You can also, in the start, if you feel you have too much berries or firewood or other thing, go here, go to trading and sell what you have too much of. But remember to go back and take no trade when you need it. And in the saw pit, they will use all the timber they can get. So always have construction reserve when you do this. Usually at least 4 for one house plot, but maybe even 8 or whatever you like. When you first start a new city, if it's only one rich deposit and the other is normal, you have a good farmland. So you should go here and check the barley farmland that is most important to make ale, so you don't build your city over the best farmland like I did here. A smart way to protect the good farmland, the barley, mark the area where it's good barley, like so. So now you remember that this is a good barley field. With the forester hut, you can do some pretty cool decor or design. You go in here, go to advanced, you mark the area where you want to add a forest, and you can, for example, make forests in this circle. If you think it's annoying that the forest is inside your houses after you build them, just go to the nearest logging camp, go to advanced, limit work area, and let them cut around the houses, and you get them removed. Now you can see the trees are gone, and just go back, go to advanced and clear work area, and they will do the closest trees. To increase your productivity, doesn't matter where, but let's take berries. You should have a granary close by that will only focus on berries. Turn off everything else. Get one people there. He will make stall, and on the furniture hut, turn off stall, remove and put one people back, so it doesn't have a stall sign. Now this person will only focus collecting berries and not run all the way to the market and back. And this person will do that instead. Production will be much better. You need extra people for do that, but after the basic is done, you should have enough people. If you upgrade to level 2 and then upgrade to level 3 after that, the house will get one extra family, and they will also produce more veggies, carrots, or apples, depend where you have the family, and you get extra population. If you want to sell stuff much faster, order a horse or two. I have already ordered one, and you can go here and add the horse. And if it doesn't have come yet, you can pre-plan it, and when it comes, you will automatically go to this trading post. Horses will carry much more items, like 50 at the time. But a person will only carry 10. If you're tired buying one on one ox and you need to wait 30 days each time, you should bring up a livestock trading post. You'll find it under the trade tab, livestock trading post. And here you can go and sign one people. And you can go on the top left here to find out how many stable spaces you have. 6 of 16. That means I can order 10 more oxes. Let's see, 14, and this will come without you need to think about it for a while. And if you want to buy even more, just put up a bunch of hitching posts. And of course it will increase, and then you can go and order even more if you have a really big town. But it costs 20, so keep in mind of that. When you use windmill, you can see how good efficiency, 0%, 39%, 100%. And that is because the windmill likes to have open field with no trees around it. If you need to place a windmill where it's a lot of trees, make sure you remove the forest to get the best efficiency around it. And then it should be much better. One of the best development points in the game is bakery, because you get double amount of bread instead of in the ovens. So you should always take that if you have good farmland. Then you also can upgrade a farmhouse to plow. You can add 2 oxes in advanced settings inside there. But you need also to have a level 2 plot and choose bakery extension. And you're good to go. So remember, go to farmhouse, go to advanced, put oxes on. You can have 2 in each farmhouse. When you get to a little bit larger city, you should have a own fire production place. Just make a road in the forest where you want it. I usually make a cross with roads, and I have two woodcutter lodge and two foresters. And then I will set day to grow three in this area and cut in the same area. And I also will have a dedicated storage close by for only firewood. Put one people there, clear the stall, go advanced, and you set the area around this big. And you do this to every building. So I replant the trees, and this will produce forever. And remember to take a dedicated storage for firewood and turn off everything else and start with one man there. They can have the stall. To get to next level, I need level 3 plots. If you take one level 2 plots, you will see what you're missing: church level, ale, and food supply and clothing. So you need to fix all of these things. So you need to start barley fields to make barley for malt, and you need a level 2 building who will produce ale. You need a tavern. That's the tavern supply part. It will take some time. And then you need to diversify your food, so you have three food stall supply. So you should go in your food setting and see what you're missing. Thank God we started with the apples, because it start kicking in soon. So you can increase the food by chickens. You need also to make shoes, so you have another clothes type, because they need two different clothing. You need to produce shoes, for example. You need also to upgrade your church. And to speed up the process of making shoes, I usually have few goats. And if you have enough money and then you think the ale part is slow because of barley need to get processed to malt, it's okay sometimes to cheat, and you can go under crafting materials, go to malt, import. Let's say you want 10. This will help the production with ale long time. And if you have problems putting up stalls, just add more to the large granary so they can get food and put up stalls. You can even add also to the large storehouse when you get more people. The timber is always stored in a logging camp, and it's only room for 28. What you can do is you start producing in one with an axe, and then you have empty around, and you can have so many as you like. And this one will fill up his own log storage. He will fill up the others, so you can have more storage of timber. But if you use an area like this, you should also have a forester hut, so you can plant trees again. Just go to the forester hut, have one people assigned, go to advanced before, just make a big area, control and scrolling. And you can also increase the forester huts if you need more. That should help a lot. Meat is broken, but we have a little bit of everything. But if you want to go honey, let's try that. So for honey, you should have a setup for 3x3 with a granary in the middle. You can ignore the part up to this patch. This is not correct with two apiaries. The more apiaries, the more you will produce. 9 apiaries. We have a granary in the middle. You add to each apiary, you add one, turn off the stalls. And you add one in the middle, only focus on honey. And if this is not enough, just copy this and do another layout with 9 more. Well, 8 apiaries and one granary in the middle. If you want to build a hub in the long away from your city, like here, you should have all the things that a big city needs, kinda. A well. You should have storage for food and storage for other items, and a small marketplace, like 9 stall or something. Not that important. They need this close by to get the requirements and so on. One problem is that you have already a marketplace over here that is 9 stall free to use, so you need to fill up this marketplace before the new one will start making stalls. Be sure to not have the first marketplace so big that this is, because you need to fill them up. But what you can do, you can go to your storage for firewood. You can increase that. They will start making up store. I have a dedicated one for bread. You can increase that. And I have the two first one. You can increase that. The market will be filled up. And they will start adding stall over here. Good stall. And you should also, of course, have people on the new storage you just put up. Then you can start an adventure in the outskirts of your region. Because the people in the city will travel to the well very many times. And if they need to walk all the way here to get to the other well, it's not very efficient. You can make larger road with stacking a lot of roads in one area, like so. You can place houses on each side, so you have that big city feeling, main road. So instead of having a small road like this, you can make a big avenue, downtown sitting feeling, with this road technique. I think it looks really cool. Add something more to the city. Big cities. You can see the cobblestone on the sides and the dirt in the middle. And one more thing that's really cool is that they will never get stuck in each other. So this will be the end of this tips and tricks guide. I did everything in one city. This is the outskirt town. And they are already have requirement for level 3.